Podcast represents the future.
Am 25. Februar 1996, während des 75. Shuttleflugs. Ein Satellitenkabel, das an der Columbia befestigt war, löste sich zufällig von der Fähre und schwebte davon. Innerhalb weniger Minuten war das 19 Kilometer lange Kabel von Dutzenden unbekannten Objekten umgeben. Die UFOs drängten sich geradezu um das zusammengerollte Kabel, das zu diesem Zeitpunkt fast 160 Kilometer von der Columbia entfernt war.
On February 25, 1996, on Space Shuttle Mission Number STS-75, NASA launched a possible breakthrough energy technology experiment. They launched a 12-mile-long electrical conductor cable called an electrodynamic tether, designed to collect high-energy electrons in the Earth's ionosphere and magnetic fields. The motion of the conductor tether across the Earth's magnetic fields induces a voltage along the 12-mile length of the tether. Utilizing estimates in the charge densities of the Earth's magnetic fields and the ionosphere, the voltage produced is expected to be up to several hundred volts per kilometer. If successful, the experiment could produce a lot of electrical power. If additional power is driven along the tether in the opposite direction to that which it normally wants to flow, the tether, in theory, could push, creating propulsion against the Earth's gravity to raise the shuttle's orbit. The advantage to this revolutionary technology in propulsion is that it does not require any rocket fuel. If successful, electrodynamic tethers could prove a way to greatly reduce the cost of in-space propulsion. For example, the International Space Station could keep itself in orbit, saving nearly $2 billion in orbital reboost rocket fuel for every 10 years of the station's operations. But on February 25th, after the 12-mile tether began producing electricity, an unexpected overload of electrical energy fluctuating between 2 and 10 times that predicted, due to inaccurate estimates in the electrical charge of the Earth's magnetic fields, ionosphere, and possibly space radiation, fried the tether conductor cable and it broke, severing it from the space shuttle.
The tether has broken at the boom. The tether has broken and is going away from us. Get it on the TV, Claude. Please get it on the TV. The tether has broken.
Copy.
Columbia and the satellite now 77 nautical miles apart. Again, that call reporting that the crew can see the tether and see the satellite. It's beautiful. This view showing satellite. Again, just moving into sunrise. 81 nautical miles now from Columbia.
Describe what you're seeing.